בתקווה שבשנה הבאה בטקס הזה יהיו כאן פחות שמות על לוח השמות הזה, זאת אומרת שכמה מהנעדרים הותרו והובאו לקבר ישראל, וכך אנחנו מחזירים את השידור לאולפן ביפו.
תודה ליאור. עד כאן טקס ההזכרה לחיילי צה"ל שמקום קבורתם לא נודע. כאן בגלי צה"ל נעבור למוזיקה שערכה סיוון מזרחי עד השעה 12.
עלינו לארץ מדרום אפריקה לפני 18 שנה. כל השנים ניסתה אמא שלי ללמוד עברית, אבל אף פעם לא קלטה. למרות שאני תמיד אומרת לה שהיא יודעת לדבר, היא לא ממש מאמינה לי. כשעלינו לארץ, גם דודה שלי גל עלתה איתנו, וכמה שנים אחר כך, סבתא שלי באה לגור איתנו גם. בפורים 96, במעבר החצייה בדיזנגוף קינג ג'ורג', היה פיגוע. שתיהן נהרגו. מאז, כל שנה אנחנו הולכים לטקס הממלכתי, וכל שנה, אמא שלי אומרת, שהיא מרגישה שהן הופכות יותר ויותר לסטטיסטיקה. יחד עם עוד 11 אנשים שאנחנו בכלל לא מכירים. אמא שלי רצתה לעשות שטיח טלאים לטקס הזיכרון בדיזנגוף. אבל היא החליטה לא לתפור בעצמה אף טלאי. אז היא הכינה רשימה. בצד שמאל, 5 תופרות. בצד ימין, 13 אנשים. ושבוע אחרי זה, הלכנו לבקר את איקה וחרמונה עתיה. המשפחה היחידה שאמא שלי הכירה מהפיקור.
How are you?
How are you?
Fine, thank you.
I wish you well in your new home.
Yeah.
You are. What we want to do, well, the idea, as you know, is that we go to the ceremony every year, and I've always felt that there's this terrible emptiness behind the stage, that there's just nothing really to focus on. I want to feel everybody there, and I thought if we made like mini quilts, not one big quilt like this, but 13 smaller quilts, each one representing the person who was killed there. Wonderful. And then they should be joined together, okay, because they were joined together in their death. What Sphere needs to do is to get a feel of Enviro. So it would be nice if you, I know it's always still hard for you, but to tell Sphere about her character, what she was doing, why she went that day to Dizengoff Center.
את אמרת שהיא הייתה רקדן, נכון? הייתה רקדנית. ואין לכם שום בגד ריקוד או משהו?
את הבגד ריקוד במצב? היה לך את כל הזה, את כל הבגדנים.
כיפה שלא מצאתי.
אבל יש לך הרבה בגדים שם.
What colors do you think Invar felt? What colors did she make you feel?
איזה צבע את חושבת ש... אופייני לה. איך?
שמונה שנים האלה לא מוסיפים...
קצת לעצמי.
כל צבעים לבשה. התמונות שהיה לנו על השולחן הזה...
איזה תמונות?
זה קרטון.
איזה תמונות?
שיהיה לנו בבית הקודם.
יש לי, נמצא את זה, זה גם אומרים.
because Dana was so young when she died, she didn't have actually, well, she didn't do so many things to have a history, to have
a legacy, a something legacy to leave or behind, something, yeah.
And they felt that the most important thing about her were her pictures, and they wanted to have something like here. They wanted to have lots of pictures, and you see the faces here and here. She liked making faces, and here
yes.
She laughed with her face, and here. Here are, they used in the memorial book the pictures from the last days, Batchen, Hadas, and Dana. What happened is that the three girls went together to Tel Aviv. Batchen was white, and Hadas was yellow. Dana was pink. In their school, the teacher put three strips of fabric, yellow, pink, and white for them. So in a way, it became a symbol. These three girls, these three colors.
Wow, I got quite goosebumps from
yeah.
that.
So the sun, the yellow and the sun from this blankie just were perfect for Hadas.
כל כהה, ובאמצע פה אני אשים צבעים שמחים מאוד, כמו שמש.
If it's possible to use something personal of hers to go into the quilt, perhaps some lace, I don't know if you know what lace is.
Lace
handles.
הדברים שלה כבר אינם, כן.
אנחנו נקנו את הכל.
It's not for sure, it just would be...
I think it's like, to remember her, it's like a big smile and smells of the kitchen, you know, the good stuff from the kitchen.
Good Canadla.
Not Canadla.
No, I think it's Mizrahi. Mizrahi, Kuba.
Not Kuba, all the Bukhari food.
Bukhari.
Rice and meat and everything.
פרופשיונלי.
כן?
אוי.
נכון, זה 7
שנים עכשיו.
לא? 9.
9 כבר.
9. שנה הבאה זה 9. שנה קרוב זה 9. 9 שנים.
9.
זה
96. נכון.
That's wonderful.
Wait, it's a long, long way to Tipperary, yes.
Oh, great.
Okay. See, I took the blue and white here, and now I have these small red drops. Actually, I should cut them as drops, I was thinking, to put them around.
When you say drops, do you mean that they should be smaller? Are you symbolizing drops of blood or something like that? For me, the only thing is I wouldn't put too many of the droplets.
No.
I think they
should. It would be too much, and just a few.
It may be 7 or 8 and only in one corner.
Yeah. Oh, yeah?
But that's how I feel. You must do how you feel. Because I actually don't want to spoil it for the beauty of it. By having so much sadness in it. I would rather see more happiness in it.
That's why I did this.
So
and that's
I like your ratio.
This behind. It's the happiness and sadness.
הייתי מתייעצת עם בעלי, אבל לא ידעתי. אז פה רק כמה, פחות או יותר, אני אראה את תמונות שאחרי האסון שהצלחנו. תמונה שמצולמת בזה, נכון? זהו,
זה מה שבחוברת?
יש לי את החוברת. אני יכולה על זה. עכשיו הבן הקטן, אם תראו אותו, בדיוק כזה.
כן?
בדיוק, הוא מסופר גם כזה.
מה?
אותו דבר. כן.
היא בדרך הפגישה היום? איפה היא? Oh, אפשר לדבר? Okay, but I need to speak to her, please. Please, can you ask her to call Marlon when she gets up? That is weird.
What?
I'll be mad.
Okay, when she doesn't come.
I think somebody else's phone.
I just don't think that is in the spirit of this quote. I just don't think it's in the... It's such a pity to ruin what has happened.
It was so important to talk to the families because so much came from them. And I felt it was very wrong that she had chosen what she thought a memorial quilt should look like and not what it should be, which is what the family would have told her. So can we think of a plan B?
Looks like it's falling on me. Seriously, to get this fear.
If you feel insecure about it, try it.
You can do it.
Yeah, I would really,
definitely can do it.
Haven't you? I've seen what you've done. You're quite original. Don't you
do something? Yeah, she's very good.
I just know that you've all done such beautiful things.
And so it might be, if you want, it's my sewing ability that worries me.
I will help you with this sewing part. She can help you.
Yeah.
You want, Marlene? No, she's been to all the interviews. We've been together to all of them.
Right.
But this time I'll come with you. We'll do the interview so we'll get the feeling. We'll sit together and we'll plan something.
Okay. I will do the interview and I will see what I can do. Okay.
Joey, do they know that we know?
No.
Joey?
They know you know.
Oh, I knew it! Oh, I can't believe those two. They thought that they could mess with us. They're trying to mess with us! They don't know that we know they know we know. Joey, you can't...
את הפגישה בסוף עם משפחת זהרון, היא רצתה לעשות לבד. רק היא ואבא שלי.
His parents were so happy to have an opportunity to talk about him and to tell stories about him again. I mean, they must have had, in the beginning, maybe they had the opportunity to do it, but it's now 9 years down the line, and you can't keep talking about these things, otherwise people think you're a little strange. And we were there more than 2 hours. Of course we could have been there much longer because they had so many stories they wanted to share with us. Please, Camilla, explain to Eddie and Ezra that I don't want to show them until Oranit comes.
You can explain.
No, they don't understand that. You must.
It's
hard to get over. Larry will tell you. Just since we were last here, I want to tell you how much I've been thinking about Kobe. Kid, she will tell you. Uh-huh. Tell him.
Yeah,
my baby. This is my baby.
Baby.
Hi, Omid.
Hello.
Hello.
One of us is Camilla.
No, Vani, because I'm staking more חיוך.
This is Aliza. I first want to tell you that when I saw this picture, it just, for me, it gave me everything. It made a very big impact on me. It gave me all my emotion, and it gave me what to work with.
לדעתי גם התמונה הזו מראה את החיים, קשת בענן, עצים.
כן.
זה מראה כמה הוא אהב לחיות.
זה בדיוק, זה תמונה נתנה לה המון המון השראה לעבודים.
וואי, איזה יופי. וואי, זה כל כך מרגש. תשמעי, זה כל כך יפה. זה ממש... הכל הכנסת פה.
I hope so. I hope I got everything.
הכל פה בפנים.
So you can see I used his son, I used his rainbow, and anything to do with animals. And this pal was his talmid, his mitzdayin. So Larry wrote me... So did I get it right? I mean, in 2 minutes it was on the radio. Yeah? It's amazing how things happen in Israel, you know, before anybody knows that it's already on the radio. And of course you hear an explosion. We were so close to it. That we turned on the radio, heard there'd been a pigua at Dizengoff Center, and I said, I'm going. Before the area's blocked off, I'm getting out of here. And by, well, 4:10, the latest, I'd gone.
Yes.
Already.
And you didn't know your mother and sister were supposed to come into Dizengoff
Center? No. It was really about 6:00 that we started getting a little worried. Up until 6:00 I wasn't. It was when Gail didn't pitch up at shul. That's, I must say, when it worried.
It started hitting you.
I never ever lost it until right at the end, which was 1:00 in the morning. That's when we learned about it.
Yeah.
And they kept phoning and saying, but they're not at this hospital, they're not at that hospital. And I kept saying, well, that's wonderful. Maybe they're disorientated, maybe...
I never thought
that they were killed. Never. Or I can't say never.
Yeah. Really?
If it entered my head, it went out straight away. It was nothing I was prepared to consider. And then Larry and my son Craig and Larry Belkin, we had these two Larrys.
Yeah.
The three of them went and decided to do the same thing themselves. And until they realized the only place they had to go was to Abu Kabir. There was nowhere else for them to look. And they still weren't very forthcoming at Abu Kabir. Then they said to them they had them on a list.
Mm-hmm.
They didn't say what list, they had them on a list.
Yeah.
And Larry phoned me and said they're on a list somewhere, but the names are wrong. And then he phoned me. He wouldn't tell me about Gail though. He just told me my mom. I just said, what about Gail? And he just couldn't tell me about her. And I know that was just after 1, a couple of minutes before 1:00. And then he came home. And then he told me about Gail.
What was Gail's surname?
Belkin.
B-A?
Belkin.
B-E-L?
B-E-L.
K-I-N. Okay.
And my mom, you wrote with Sylvia Bernstein.
Yeah, I've got that.
I mean, like, this is so typical of my mom.
Colorful. Let's say you said, just oranges and greens.
You can see her choices of, you know, she always made a little something. And
every time she went past the mirror, she would stop.
Check and make sure that she left the house
perfect before she walked out the front door, you know.
But if your mum will be a little bit more fun.
Yeah.
At the moment, it doesn't mean to say it's going to work out that way, but this particular design, you can do it in the soft colours, it can be the background. That's fine.
So,
enjoy.
That's my mum. Then we'll talk about
your sister.
My sister. Anything, if you've got something with a movie in it, it would be very significant for me.
Mm-hmm.
Got something with a movie in it?
A movie camera.
It's
a large collection of novelty prints.
Yeah.
I had to watch it.
Okay. Do you just want the word movies then?
השנה, בטקס בדיזנגוף, בא לי שנחגוג. שכולנו נעמוד שם ונמחא לעצמנו כפיים. שתהיה מין מהפכה כזאת. שאולי יהיה משהו יפה כבר ביום הזה.
איזה יופי, יצא. מה שלומך?
אז אני לא קיבלתי כזה.
כן, יש לי כזה. רק שנייה.
תגידי.
Can you give me the one for Yovav?
זכר י"ג יקירינו אשר נגדעו מאיתנו.
Are you okay?